Sarah Palin's super PAC is in a fight with Barack Obama's super PAC, and nobody likes any of Mitt Romney's super PACs. Why can't these super PACs just get along? This chapter began when comedian Bill Maher gave $1 million to Barack Obama's super PAC. Now, normally, I wouldn't talk about another comedian with a better career than mine, especially one that could hire me as a writer, although he does not. But Bill Maher crossed the line when he gave $1 million to a super PAC. He became a participant instead of an observer. He became a setup for one of my punchlines. Now, I could have used that $1 million, but that's not the point. That's not why I'm talking about Bill Maher. I want to make that perfectly clear. Now, I'm all for it. Get that money out of Hollywood. Send it to Washington and Madison Ave. Oh, sure, I have a one-man show which I could probably produce for only $500,000, or $950,000, actually, and that's $50,000 in Bill Maher's pocket.
Guaranteed profit right there.
And if he wants to give that to Obama's PAC, he should go right ahead. Although I do have a short film I'd like to direct for FunnyOrDie.com, which I'm sure I could bring in at only $490,727 and 50 cents. $73 in Bill Maher's pocket. Well, $72.50. But that's not the point I'm trying to make. I'm sure the President of the United States could use the money. Oh, sure, I have a sitcom pilot I wrote for myself, which I could probably produce for a flat million. But I guess Clear Channel could use that money, too. Anyway, that's not the point I'm trying to make. The point I was trying to make is that conservatives preach that money is free speech. Bill Maher exercised his right to their kind of free speech by giving $1 million to Barack Obama's super PAC. And Sarah Palin used the millions from her super PAC to try to cancel out his $1 million. Why not just give it to me? I have a nice middle school recital about Alaska I could produce for only $400,000. But again, I digress. Anyway, in an effort to deflect attention from the Republicans' war on women and Rush Limbaugh's attack on women, far more intelligent than himself, Sarah Palin's super PAC, She PAC, produced a short attack ad for Obama for accepting money from Bill Maher because of some joke he made about her frisky daughter. Now, in the commercial, Palin's PAC violates copyright law by stringing together a series of very funny Bill Maher monologue jokes, which I hadn't seen before because I don't get HBO, in which he told jokes about Palin and her daughter. Palin was so offended by these jokes that she paid someone to edit them together so she could illegally rebroadcast them to an audience larger than the original HBO audience. Sarah Palin is really hoping you'll watch this video that derides her daughter. Thanks, Mom. I feel sorry for Bristol. Her mother and the Republican Party have used her to spout propaganda written by others since the 2008 election. In a new slick multimedia blog, which is being produced under Bristol's name, which she began only weeks ago, Bristol attacks Obama for accepting Maher's donation. The blog embeds CPAC's video, and chances are the blog entry is coordinated with her mother and CPAC. You can fool some of the Republicans all of the time. You know what the best thing? You know what the best thing about this video is? When it's over, the YouTube suggested links are to Bill Maher's most recent free stand-up special, Crazy Stupid Politics, in which I'm sure there are bound to be Palin jokes, and to Alexander Pelosi's recent documentary short, which was shown on Real Time, and it's about the Mississippi Tea Party, and it was less than flattering. Thanks for the free advertising, CPAC. And don't forget to say Fridays at 9. When super PACs start advertising about other super PACs, it's time to pack in the super PACs. I'm James Tripp, and I'll be back next week with another Trippatorial.